man in my room, sir.
Hello and welcome to my YouTube channel. I am Espoir Duvide, and today I'm going to play a game called Lucky Day. I have a feeling this ain't going to be so lucky. Who are you again? I am Espoir, means hope in French. Your phone buzzed as you walked out of the office building. Taking it out of your pocket, you spot a new message from a friend. The weekend wasn't too busy for you. Not until now, that is. Hey, could you stop by the pet store and buy me some stuff? It's not too far from your workplace. Need it. ASAP. Sent you the money already. Thanks.
Daisy! Why are you meow-meowing?
Seriously? They didn't even ask if you were okay with doing that. What if you were actually busy? What then? What if right after your prior engagement you had to save an orphan from a burning building? These orphans won't wait. Whatever.
Daisy!
Whatever, you aren't doing any noble causes like saving orphans from buildings today. Or any day for that matter. But the orphans, Espoir! Being the great, wonderful friend that you are, you send off a reply as you get in your car. As your friend said, it really wasn't that far. Pulling into the crowded parking lot, you hype yourself up to get out of the car and into the store. Regardless of your thoughts on pets and animals, you really didn't want to be in a crowded place right now, especially at a pet store where irresponsible owners could be rampant. You just wanted a quiet weekend. You wanted to go home and sleep or indulge in a hobby, but mostly sleep. Ah, yes, sleep. Very good. After a few seconds of mental ping-pong, you turn the engine off and get out of your car, wallet in hand. It's gonna be quick. Is it? Is it going to be quick? Or is it going to be the worst day of your life? In and out. You could be placed on a speedrun website for how fast you'll get the supplies. You're hyping this up, main character. You're hyping this up. This isn't gonna go well. With these thoughts hyping you up, you step inside the crowded store. Walking briskly with your phone in one hand, you scan the signs near the tops of the aisles as you search for what you had to pick up for your friend. Oh. Ow. Uh-oh. It looks like you bumped into someone. Sorry about that. You help the person up. The person gives you a blank look, though he seems apologetic as he shakes his head. No, it's my fault. I was just standing in the middle of the aisle. Sorry. He kind of looks like he's going to cry with the way his mouth is pressed into a thin, trembling line. This guy just looks lost in general. What kind of person spaces out in the middle of the aisle anyway? Was he lost or something? Your question was answered as his gaze wanders again. Anyone could tell that this guy was looking for something, but was too lost, and maybe even a bit overwhelmed. It was the weekend, and the store was busy. There were no employees around to help this guy. His face paled a bit as he kept turning in all sorts of directions, trying to find something, but being too overwhelmed to take a single step forward.
Aww, I'll help you, baby. I'm probably gonna regret it, but I'll help you. If I have the choice.
You could help him, but it'd be a time lost to the speedrun challenge you imposed on yourself before stepping foot outside your car.
Yeah, I'll help the boy. I'm gonna regret it, but I'm gonna help him.
You may not be saving orphans from a burning building, but you could probably help this random guy.
I love helping random guys. I often regret it in these games.
Hey, do you need help finding something? The guy turns to look at you and nods wordlessly.
So, what did you need help finding?
The hamsters. He mumbles it out, looking down at his feet.
Hamsters?
He nods and looks up at your face.
Does he want to look at the hamsters? Aww.
Hamsters. He nods again. It didn't really look like he was looking at you. More like he was looking at something behind you, or at your forehead. Maybe he was just bad at eye contact.
Okay, let's go then. Let's find them dare hamsters.
You look around and spot the sign indicating products related to small animals. Seems like a good place to start. Walking over, you glance over your shoulder to make sure he was following along. He followed closely, though made sure he kept some distance, so as not to touch you on accident. It seems like he avoided touching people like the plague, expertly weaving between people without so much as brushing against them. After some walking around, you two finally arrived at the glass displays. Hamsters were sleeping in the bedding, some sniffing around while others drank water and ran in a wheel.
Aww, hamsters.
The guy you helped had a slight smile as he watched them, eyes soft. His expression was a far cry from the nervous wreck you had bumped into a few minutes ago. Thank you. He was still looking at the hamsters as he spoke. As you were about to turn to leave, he spoke again. Hey, what's your name? If you don't mind telling me, that is. I didn't get a chance to ask.
Espoir, I gotta go now. Glad I could help.
Gotta get back to that speed run. Alright, we saved the animals this time, but next time those animals aren't getting saved.
You answer quickly as you leave to grab what you needed. As you walked around the store, it felt like something was behind you the whole time. But whenever you looked behind you, nothing eye-catching was in your vision. Brushing it off as paranoia, you head to the checkout and carry the bags to your car.
There better not be no shenanigans behind me.
It's a quiet drive to your friend's house. A dull ache was starting to bloom in your head. You seem to understand why they ended up asking you to do this. The distance you had to drive was pretty far. Eventually, you pull into the neighborhood. It didn't take long to find your friend's house and park.
What kind of pet do they have? May I see it? Is it a doggo? Is it a kitty? I want to see the baby.
Quickly sending a text to your friend that you were outside in the driveway, you lean back in your chair and sigh. Home was so close, yet so far. You briefly wonder if the guy from the pet store was still looking at the hamsters. It felt nice to help someone out. Before you could think about it a bit more, there's a knock at your window. Your friend gives you a wide smile as you open the door.
You are a lifesaver.
Yeah, I know.
Handing your friend the goods, they thank you again.
Here, I made too much to eat, and I know you love this stuff.
Oh, thanks.
A $10 bill was sitting on top, held in place by their thumb. You take the wrapped food from their hands. It's still warm, freshly made, it seems. You pocket the bill as well. Closing the car door, you wave goodbye as you pull out of the driveway.
Oh, that was nice.
You got some good food and $10 in gas money.
Yeah.
The thought of a warm, home-cooked meal helps you deal with the headache that was plaguing you better. Maybe this wasn't a total waste of time after all. You helped out two people. Surely your good deeds will be rewarded one way or another.
What goes around comes back around, right?
At least, that's what you had hoped would happen.
Oh, no. The following week, it felt like something was out to get you. You were met with trouble at practically every turn, and by the end of the week you were absolutely exhausted. At its worst, it felt like whatever higher being existed was trying to strike you down in the worst possible way. At its best, it was an inconvenience annoying you left and right as you tried to survive the day. Whichever end of the spectrum it was, each day ended with you stumbling into your home and passing out in exhaustion. Not even the weekends were safe. Your time was taken up searching for your bicycle and frantically fixing tons of errors and mistakes on a team project. Honestly, you wish you could just catch a break already. Enough of this bullcrap week. If superpowers were real, you'd probably want time manipulation so that you could pause everything and sleep for 10 years. Unfortunately, you aren't that lucky. Staring at the date on your phone, you sigh and shut it off. It's a new week. Hopefully this one is better than the last. Clocking out and changing out of uniform, you briefly wonder if you should take a more scenic route home. There was still a bit of daylight to burn after all. A few extra steps wouldn't hurt. Walking down the street, you absent-mindedly decide to walk through the nearby neighborhood.
I just remembered, that guy didn't want to touch anybody, but we bumped into him. Oh no.
A park was nearby and the houses looked pretty, the sidewalk lined with tall trees that swayed gently in the breeze. The ambience and general vibe always seemed to have a calming effect. You enjoyed taking this route after a tiring shift. Passing by the houses one by one, your eyes eventually landed on a yard sale sign. You palmed your wallet. Did you carry cash today? Curious, you followed the sign and eventually came up to a house with its yard full of knickknacks and other such things. The homeowner greeted you as you inspected what was for sale. Nothing was particularly eye-catching, not until you noticed a familiar logo. Picking it up, you realized it was an official plush from one of your favorite pieces of media. It was produced in limited quantity, with second-hand sales on auction sites costing 100 times more than the original price. You were shocked to find such sought-after merchandise in such perfect condition, aside from the very light wear and such. The homeowner must have noticed your piqued interest as you were inspecting the item in shock. There was no way in heck you were going to pass up this opportunity. You deserve to treat yourself for once, especially after all that's happened. You quickly pulled your wallet out, asking the seller how much they wanted. Upon hearing the price, you had to stop your jaw from hitting the floor. No effin' way they were selling it for that cheap. Paying out the cash, you walked away from the yard sale, a happy camper. Aww. If you could, you'd throw in a skip and click your heels together like a whimsical fellow living in the Victorian era. You quickly made your way home, protecting your new purchase with your life. When you arrived, you looked for a spot in your house to display your new item. Eventually, you found some space in your room. Settling on a shelf in your room, you make some space and put it in place. You couldn't believe your luck. Maybe things were taking a turn for the better after all. Hmm? Huh? You look around your room, then up at the smoke detector. Did it beep? You squinted the detector before grabbing a chair and testing the battery. Hmm? It's fine. Then what was that? Oh, snap. What the heck is that beeping noise? Looking around, you back yourself into a corner. After a bit, you heard another beep. It better not be my brand new toy. It better not. It came in the direction of... You stand in front of the shelf, squinting. Eventually, another beep sounded. Don't do this to me, plush toy. You wouldn't be a bomb, would you? You wouldn't do that to me. You wouldn't do this to me. It was coming from the newly purchased plush. Picking it up off the shelf, you back up and sit on your bed, taking a closer look. Oh, the beep was definitely coming from here. But did you really want to cut it open? You had just bought it, not to mention how sought after this particular piece of merchandise was. Darn it. Gosh darn it, this is difficult. Think about it later. If it's a bomb, we'll find out the hard way. Why is the stuffed animal beeping? While you do feel a bit curious, you brush it off and decide to not cut open the merchandise, at least not right now. You feel a sinking pit of anxiety in your stomach, but the guilt of cutting it open wins you over. For now, you decide to put it in a box in your closet. Hopefully you can't hear the beeping from there. After putting it in its place, you get on your laptop and spend the rest of the evening browsing the web before heading to bed. Today was pretty good. Okay, good. We are not exploded. Haha, that's good. A package would be coming by the end of today. Maybe it was all the stress, stockpiling during the last week, but you made an impulse buy when online window shopping. Just to treat yourself. You had completely forgotten about it until you woke up to an email from the website. It would be delivered at 9 p.m. A glance at the clock is all you need to keep your pacing around. Any minute now. Ever since you had arrived home from work, you had been biding your time. Catching up on shows, watching lengthy video essays, or just mindless doom-scrolling on social media. You tried to distract yourself from the excitement of an incoming package. Another walk around the kitchen counters, check the phone again, look at the doorway. No doorbell ringing, no knock. Another walk around it is... Ah! Halfway through it felt like the 100th, millionth lap around the kitchen, you finally heard a knock at the door. practically bolting to the door, you open the door and sign for the signature. Your highly anticipated impulse buy was finally here. Was it worth it? Probably not. But you deserve a treat after surviving the last week. Setting the box on the kitchen counter, you cut open the packaging and unbox the purchase you made. As you were discarding the leftover packing and boxes, you heard something plasticky hit the floor.
Ooh. Ooh.
Crouching down to pick it up, you came across a USB flash drive. Weird. You didn't order this. Did it fall into the box by accident? Is this someone else's order? Pocketing it for now, you finish cleaning up and head over to your room. Once you're sitting comfortably with the laptop in your lap, you plug in the flash drive and open up its contents.
You should not put in a mysterious flash drive into your main computer.
It's hard to stop your jaw from hitting the trackpad. Hundreds, if not thousands, of folders, each labeled with its contents. The first folder catches your eye. It's a popular show you had been wanting to watch recently, but was taken off the air. Clicking in, your eyes almost bulge out of your skull as its contents reveal every episode in high quality.
Oh.
You quickly back out and start going through the other folders. Music, video games with emulators, TV shows and animation, the flash drive carried everything of interest.
Of my interest?
Could something like this really be ordered at an online retailer? Whatever the case may be, you're definitely holding on to this.
Ooh.
As you explore the folders, you eventually come across a folder that was hidden inside of an empty one. Clicking on it informs you that it needs administrative privilege to enable viewing and editing. What could possibly be in here? None of the other folders so far had something like this.
Maybe ignore it for now. Ha 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 ha. We'll deal with that later, just like the potential bomb in my stuffed animal.
You keep it on the drive for now. You'll decide what to do with it later. Who knows what might be on it? What if there's a virus or something? It's beginning to get late. You had no idea how long you were scrolling until you looked at the time. There really was a lot of stuff on the little flash drive. Closing the laptop, you wind down and get ready for bed. What a lucky day.
Ha!
Not looking a gift horse in the mouth.
It's your day off today. One of the two you'll have off week. You spend most of the day lounging around until you decided to get something more productive done. Opening your trusty laptop, you started absent-mindedly surfing the web until a light bulb lit up in your head. Nowadays, there are a ton of streaming or premium services for everything imaginable. Television, online video gameplay, music. Split across different apps instead of one consolidated site for each form of media, it's easy to have your wallet drained in the span of a month. Looking at your bank account statement from last month, you decided that today you'd be canceling your subscriptions to a few services. That money spent for ad-free streaming could definitely be spent better elsewhere. Starting with the most expensive service you're subscribed to, you navigate to the site and open up the account settings. On the payment page, you skim over as you scroll to the bottom to cancel. However, something catches your eye. The next payment due date. Usually, the one renews around the same time every month. Tomorrow, it'd renew. At least, that's what you remember. Looking at the date on the page, it's due next month instead of tomorrow. That's strange. Checking your bank account statement again confirms your thought. You paid for the service a month ago, so it should be due around this time of the month rather than next month. No recent transactions or pending balance notices indicate that you've paid it earlier either. Keeping the tab open, you go down the list of subscription services you wanted to cancel. Each one had the same discrepancy in due payments.
Investigate further.
That's not right. Clicking on payment information, you review the details in the section. Immediately, your eyes lock on the payment method. Every subscription service is linked to your card, but what you know and what you see are two different things. Underneath the payment method is a PayPal you don't recognize linked to your account. That's definitely not right.
I mean, gift horse in the mouth, but, you know.
You quickly go through each account and find that they're all linked to the same PayPal. Do you get hacked? But why would they pay for it? Isn't the point of hacking someone's account to leech off of their benefits? You take note to the email address, link to the payment method, and open up the email composer. Determined to get to the bottom of this mystery, you type in a short message and send it off. There were a few questions on your mind, but you keep your email short and straight to the point. You better put a thank you on that! Sending the email on its way, you lean back in your chair, staring at the ceiling to think. After a few minutes, you get a notification. Uh-oh. Leaning forward, you see that it's a reply from the email. The initial message you sent was a question of whether or not they knew their PayPal was linked to several of your accounts. You expected it to be a misunderstanding, but the reply you got filled you with unease. I linked it to your account on purpose. Sorry, am I being a bother? Who the heck was this person, and why would they pay for your subscriptions themselves? Typing up another reply, you ask them exactly that. You get a response a few minutes later. I'm Oliver Morgan. Oh. As for why, well, it's because I like you. You weren't sure if you felt flattered or creeped out. The name this person gave you rang no bells whatsoever. Oh, it rang some of my bells. You sound like someone that I'm eventually going to give a black eye to. After a few more back-and-forth emails, you end up becoming more and more creeped out. The general tone of his messages were polite, but the content of each one unnerved you. Each one just preached about how he loved you and had been watching you for a while. Is there a camera in that stuffed animal? Apparently, he had seen you worrying about the subscriptions and took it upon himself to help you. At this point, you were thoroughly creeped out. Would you watching me through my plushie, sir? Sir! Typing your final email, you asked him to leave you alone, or you'll call the authorities. Sending it off, you block his address and start changing your passwords. You cancel all the payments as well. As nice as it would be to have all this free stuff handed to you on a silver platter, the situation was just too creepy. Once you were finished, you shut your laptop off and got up to get ready for bed. That night, you double-checked the locks and windows around your house. Just in case. A knocking sound wakes you up. Hey! Rolling over, you check the time. 5 a.m. Who the heck is knocking on your door this early in the morning? Ah! As you get up, the knocking gets more and more intense. Fists were practically slamming on the door as you groggily got up. Ah! Opening the door to your room, you abruptly ran into something. Well, actually, it's someone. No! Morgan, in my house at 5 a.m., this is not wake-up time. This is sleep time, sir. If you're gonna stalk me, you do it at noon. Nobody is awake. We are not awake at 5 a.m. We don't do that here. Looking at their face, you're met with a surprised look from the blonde man. Have you seen this guy somewhere before? Realization sets in, causing you to jump away and slam the door shut in his face. What the F are you doing in my house? I just wanted to talk. Did you break in? Well, I mean, I did, but you weren't having this. Running to your bed, you start dialing the police. Without you holding the door shut, Oliver opens it. When he sees you on the phone with the police, he quickly walks over to try and stop you. Pushing him away when he got too close, you try to escape somewhere else. However, a grip on your ankle stops you in place. Oh, I forgot, he's very feisty. Looking down, Oliver is grabbing your ankle with both hands, looking up at you pleadingly. Can't we just talk? Kick him in the head, give him the boot. Hit him with your foot, consider talking to him, and then hit him in the head. He's being a bit forceful, but consider talking to him. You use your other foot to kick him in the head. Somehow, you manage to kick him hard enough to knock him out. That was surprisingly easy. Poor guy, he's getting beat up by me at every turn.
You summon the hands, sir. You're gonna get them.
You drag him to the bathroom and close the door, holding the door shut. Just in case. Finishing your call with emergency services, all you're left to do is hold the door shut and hope he doesn't wake up.
I wonder if all of those would have led to the same thing. Either way, you're getting pummeled with the foot, sir.
It takes about half an hour for the authorities to arrive and take him away. After some questioning, you're allowed to rest easy. Hopefully that's the last you'll see of him for a while. Ending 4. Breaking and entering is illegal, by the way.
Sir? How dare you? How dare you?
Okay, about this beeping plushie that we have, crack it open. You carry it to the kitchen and set it on the counter. Taking out a knife, you silently apologize to your fellow fans as you prepare to cut into the merch. It's difficult to summon the resolve to actually start. After a few seconds of staring, you realize that there's a tiny little slit in the fabric. You put the knife down and push a finger in. Tearing it open a bit wider, your finger brushes against something hard. Picking out some of the stuffing, you reach in and pull out the small object hidden within.
Oh. I knew it. That's a camera.
There's a small camera that was hidden inside the plush you just bought.
That's my nightmare. Well, not really, but that'd be incredibly unfortunate.
Okay. You stare at the camera until it beeps again, wincing at the sound. Inspecting the camera, you find that there's a slot in it for an SD card. Popping it out, you leave the kitchen. Quickly grabbing the laptop from your room, you return to your living room and open it up. The SD card easily inserts into the slot, and you're able to explore the contents. You navigate to the folder directory and look at the contents. Several videos were saved on it, and you watch them, one by one. As you go through the videos, you come across what seems to be the test recording.
Is that?
A pair of hands is up to the camera, positioning it within what looks like a stuffing. You make a wild guess that this is when it was planted inside the plush. When he backs up, you can see his face more clearly.
Huh? That's... It's Hamster Man! It's Hamster Man from the hamster store!
Is that the guy you met from the pet store? From, like, a week ago? What the fluff? You watch in morbid curiosity as he walks to the yard sale and hands it to the homeowner, who seems eager to be able to sell another item. Before you could go through another video, a knock on your door makes your blood run cold. You slowly turn towards the sound, grabbing the knife on the counter and walking cautiously to the front door. Looking through the peephole on the door, you feel the hairs on your neck rise.
It's him.
Oh, no. He's just standing there awkwardly, waiting for you to open the door. A cloth mask is over his face, but you recognize the distinct blonde hair with strawberry blonde tips.
Sir?
You're unsure of what to do at this point. Backing away from the door, you consider your options.
Oh, don't make me choose.
Call the cops? No, they wouldn't get here in time.
Let him in?
No, you're not that effing stupid. He's definitely going to do something.
Run?
Well, your car is in the garage. Not a bad choice, actually. As quietly as you can, you pocket your keys and make your way to your car in the garage. Hopping in your car, you grip the steering wheel with one hand, key in the ignition. The garage door opens pretty slowly, but if you time it just right, you can drive out with only a few scratches on the roof. Goodness! Your life is worth more than a car you got from a second-hand dealership. Starting the car, you open the garage. The moment it's open wide enough, you slam your foot on the gas.
We out! Bye! See ya!
Bolting out of the garage, you turn as quickly as you can out of the driveway and make your escape.
Oh no!
In the rearview mirror, you can see the stranger watching you drive off.
Oh, that's creepy. Oh, that's creepy. I don't mean the mask. I mean just him just standing there watching you like, where are you going?
Wait, but if you just run away, what will he do? Considering your options, you decide to
run him over, hit him with the car,
turn around the car and run him over. Try hitting him with your car. These options all sound similar. I don't want to hit him with my car, because then I'm the one going to jail for vehicular manslaughter. Turn the car around and run him over? You make a U-turn and drive back towards your house. He's in the middle of the road now, surprised to see that you came back. It looks like he made an attempt to run after the car, sir! Not stopping, you press on the gas, aiming right for him. Espoir. Espoir, that's vehicular manslaughter. That's a felony. Stop! Okay, fine. You do weird flex, but you do you, me. When he realizes that you're about to run him over, he tries to run out of the way, but you chase him down until you manage to hit him with your car. Jesus, you're like, not today. We are not getting any stalkers today. We're not doing that here. Ooh. Bringing the car to a stop, you step out and look at the man who collapsed on the road. Is he dead? Did you just kill a man? Well, he kind of had it coming with the whole hidden camera and showing up at your house stuff. You hope your neighbors didn't just witness you running someone over. Nobody saw me commit a crime, okay? Taking your phone out of your pocket, you call the police and text your friend. Despite barely even starting, looks like this week is a bust. Ending 2. Hit and run. I seriously just ran him over? I just ran him over? Okay. Okay, so we left it, we thought about it later, cracked it open, what if we just leave it alone? You ignore it and choose not to cut it open. You're just grateful you managed to get such a steal on such a rare plush. There's no way you'll butcher your new merch mere minutes after buying it. After putting it in its place, you get on your laptop and spend the rest of the evening browsing the web before heading to bed. Today was pretty good. Okay, about this thing. Let's crack this sucker open. Open this mysterious file folder. You decide to open the folder. The laptop seems to lag a bit as it struggles to load the contents. Ooh. However, once it loads, you can feel your blood run cold. Countless photos and videos. The subject varied from each, but they all shared a common trait. They were all related to you. Your house, your car, your belongings. You. A pit begins to form in your stomach as you scroll through the folder. It's practically never ending. Whoever took these photos and videos had been tailing you for the past week. The thought made you sick. You had been so overwhelmed you failed to realize you were being stalked. Paranoia sets in as you quickly get up from where you're sitting, looking around. The window curtain is open, just a crack. Closing the curtains, you grab your laptop. Opening your closet, you take a seat in the dark and open your laptop back up. You could use this flash drive as evidence, couldn't you? Would the police even believe you? Oh, this flash drive I randomly found that totally doesn't belong to me has photos and videos of my house. Yeah, right. They definitely believe that. You definitely wouldn't be written off as a nutjob wasting the precious time of the police. As you rack your brain for ideas, a light bulb switches on. What if you could investigate things yourself? Clicking on one of the photos, an image of a shirt you had lost, you open the properties for the pic. There. The metadata for the image file. Darn, whoever took these photos used a pretty expensive camera. As you scroll through the metadata, your eyes laid on the GPS section. Latitude and longitude. Taking your phone out and opening the map app, you type in the coordinates you saw on the screen. That's some pretty impressive detective work. The location wasn't too far away, walking distance. All right, you're doing this. We'll show up at his house. And then he'll run us over with his car. Crawling out of your closet, you stand up and put your laptop away. As you put a jacket on, you consider bringing a weapon. The Swiss Army knife in the junk drawer will have to do. Bringing an entire kitchen knife wouldn't be good unless you want to be mistaken as a serial killer. Armed and ready, you start heading out to where the images were taken.
After a bit of walking and a few detours to avoid being seen by cars, you arrive at your destination. Finding yourself in an old park, nature seems to have been reclaiming the space with all the overgrown grass and plants. Checking the map app, it's clear. This is where the photo was taken. Some sort of clue had to be nearby. Turning on the flashlight on your phone, you begin your search as you part the tall grass with your other hand to see the ground better. After a bit of searching, you come across a cardboard box that sticks out more than the trash you've seen. It was notably cleaner, and it seems like whoever had put it here was trying to hide it if the cloth over it wasn't anything to go by. Holding your breath, you pull the cloth off and open up the box. It's the shirt you lost. And a sock that you thought had gone missing in the wash. Dude, you're taking my socks? Come on now. Is that the lint from the lint tray of your dryer? Alright, come on now, dude. You can feel the anxiety that had risen in your chest seize your heart as you go through the other contents of the box. Who did this? Why? Why you? In your state of paranoia, you suddenly became aware of something watching you, a presence, right behind you. The realization makes your blood run cold. You barely have the time to reach for your Swiss Army knife before a cloth is over your nose and mouth.
Oh no!
Flailing around desperately, you try to scream for help, only for the cloth and hand over your face to muffle your cries. Lungs burning, you're left with no choice but to inhale the cloth. It isn't long before your head grows fuzzy and your body goes limp. The last thing you see is a man with blonde hair, eyes apologetic as his mouth opens to speak. Sorry. Ending 3. Secret Stash.
How dare you? How dare you, sir? How could you do this to me? I can't believe you've done this. Okay. What if we just leave him alone? What if we go all the way back to the beginning and just go on your way? Sorry, can't help you, friend. We're speed strats. We're speedrunning this. We're skipping steps. We're glitching through the walls. We don't have time for this.
You didn't have time. You're already tired as is, and you just wanted to head home. Heck, you didn't even want to be here. Silently wishing the stranger the best, you head on your way to the aisle and pick up whatever your friend needed. Carrying the bag back to your car, you start the engine and pull out the parking lot. You briefly wonder if the guy from the pet store found what he was looking for. Before you could think about it more, there's a knock on your window. Your friend gives you a wide smile as you open the door. Handing your friend the goods, they thank you again. Here, I made too much to eat and I know you love this stuff.
Oh, thanks!
The coming weeks go by as normal, and nothing out of the ordinary happens. As expected.
Ending 1. Normal week. Well, fine. Okay, last time I investigated further, but what if I just, cancel later instead of now?
Well, it's not like you were in a particular rush to cancel your subscriptions. You suppose you could just cancel it next month instead of now? Closing the tabs, except for one, you decide to spend the rest of the day binging a series you had been meaning to watch.
Nice.
Today is another day off. A good day to be active, going out to exercise, whether you want to or not.
Most likely, I do not.
You recently found the bicycle that you lost last week while walking home from work a day or so ago. In celebration, your friend wanted to go for a scenic bike ride on your day off. Right now, you're hanging out near the trail waiting for your friend, headphones are in your ears, playing your tunes. After a few minutes of waiting, you hear someone biking up and stopping next to you. It's your friend. Greeting them, you two walk idly as you're ready for the ride. After a few moments, you're ready and head on your way. The weather was pretty good today. You feel lucky as the slight breeze refreshes your body.
Oh, how lovely.
Not to mention the stunning scenery around you. At a few points on your ride, you paused for a break and took in the scenery around you. Even if you weren't too thrilled about exercising today, the great weather and beautiful landscape surrounding you made up for it. After biking as much as you could, you eventually looped back around to where you started. Your friend stopped behind you, stretching tiredly and taking a sip of their water. As you took your helmet off, you watched your friend take their phone out. Now that you were closer to civilization, your phones had signal. Your friend tapped away on their phone as you stretched out your limbs. A few minutes later, there was a tap on your shoulder. Turning to your friend, you were met with a face painted with worry. Uh-oh.
Whoa, what's wrong?
Well, I think we were being tracked during our ride.
What?
Your friend raises their phone to eye level. The screen showed a notification. An AirTag was found moving along with you.
Is it not your AirTag? What's an AirTag? I don't know that. What is that?
They shook their head. Let's check your bike. You lost it recently, right? Maybe somebody planted it there.
Oh, yeah.
You nod reluctantly and turn to your bike.
Oh.
Searching the bike, you eventually come across a small AirTag underneath the seat.
Oh.
Holding the small disc between your fingers, you think about your next course of action.
I kind of want to hold on to it for now.
This is definitely something you should look into. But maybe we're not right now. You don't want to worry your friend.
I think I'll hold on to this for now.
Your friend still looks worried as you pocket the AirTag.
Are you sure? Will you be okay?
Yeah, I'll be okay. Promise. Let's head back. I'll text you when I'm home. Reassuring your friend, you grab your bike. Your friend still isn't entirely convinced, but grabs their bike nonetheless. You both head off after that, chatting along the way. After dropping your friend off at their house, you head on your way home. You spend the rest of the evening winding down to mentally prepare for work tomorrow.
Not worrying about the tailing thing that you just got?
It's another day of work. Not a particularly bad one, nor was it good. You'd say you were rather ambivalent about it all. Better than last week, if anything, you suppose. Last week, you were tasked with a team project. Regardless of how well you did when working in groups, it ended up being the most irritating project you had the displeasure of working on. The co-workers you had to work with were unreliable and arrogant, opposing any change you proposed. Working on the project itself was no problem, but having to work with team members made it an absolute drag. As the thought crossed your mind, you ran into one of the co-workers you had to work with on the project.
Oh, sorry.
Wait. Before you could walk past, he grabs your shoulder and stops you.
Huh?
Hey, I'm really sorry about last week. I realized I was insufferable to work with, and it was absolutely my fault that the project was botched. Think I could treat you to some food after this?
Oh, I don't know.
I insist, really. Any place you want. I'll be waiting around outside after work, okay? You aren't given a chance to respond as he pats you on the shoulder and walks away. Well, it's not like you had any plans after work today anyways. Free food doesn't sound half bad either. You didn't really want to have microwave dinner two nights in a row. With the free food motivating you, you continue to go about the workday, looking forward to it. As you left work, you text your coworker to let him know you're outside. You look around. He's nowhere in sight. Well, that's weird. Checking your text, you can see that he's already read your message. You decide to wait around a little bit more, just in case. 5 minutes pass, then 10 minutes. Around the 20-minute mark, your patience was starting to wear thin. Before you could send another text, you received two messages from your coworker. Can't make it. Sorry. Buy yourself something good. Coworker number 23.
Money up. Gurngi? Gurngi sent you $50.
What? First of all, why is that his name on the app? Second of all, he can't make it? You're not about to decline a free $50, but on the other hand, it's a bit suspicious. This coworker wasn't one to just flake like that. He may be hard to work with, but he wasn't unreliable.
Oh well.
Gift horse.
Oh, well. Oh, well. $50. Free food. Thank you. Did our little blonde friend get to our co-worker? Because he was going to get us dinner. I guess we'll find out when I pick the other choice.
Well, that's odd, but you suppose there's nothing you can do about it. After a bit of thinking, you decide to accept the money. On your way home, you decide to treat yourself to a restaurant you like. You make sure to bring home some leftovers as well. It's not anything special, but the food was good at least. You'll have to thank your co-worker the next time you see him. I have a feeling we're not going to see him no more. Hopefully the next team project you work on will go better too. The week has come to a close and time marches on towards the next day. This day has been as normal as ever with no events standing out. Looks like your lucky streak has come to an end. Maybe the balance of bad luck and good luck has been restored. Although the week was a bit strange at times. Some things raised your suspicions, and in retrospect, maybe you should have been more curious. What would have gone differently had you not been so impassive and accepting of each stroke of luck? Well, nothing you can do now. It's not like you can rewind time and see what happened. Regardless, the thought will linger on your mind for a while. Ending 7. What a strange week. Huh. Okay, what if we get to the bottom of this and contact the owner?
Do you think we could find out who this belongs to?
Yeah, hold on. You watch your friend open up an app and pluck the AirTag from your hands. After a little bit, an email and phone number popped up. Exchanging a glance with your friend, you type the phone number into your phone.
Should I text or call or...
Maybe we should go to the cops.
How much help would the cops be, though?
I don't know. After a bit of back and forth with your friend, you both agree on calling with the speaker on. You both headed to a nearby cafe and sat outside, bikes leaning on the table. Taking your phone out, you look at your friend before gathering your resolve and calling the number.
Huh?
A ringtone could be heard nearby, sir! I was kind of hoping that would happen.
It looks like your friend heard it, too. The two of you look around before the ringtone is suddenly cut off.
Oh, we got you now.
Someone answered the call.
Hello?
The voice on the other end sounded familiar. Exchanging a glance with your friend, you start talking.
Hi.
Hello.
I found an AirTag linked to this number. I was wondering if you lost it.
How is somebody going to lose it, carefully hiding it under your bicycle seat that was stolen?
Oh no, I didn't lose it. Is that so? Sorry for bothering you then. I put it there on purpose.
Ah.
What?
I put it there on purpose, the AirTag. Your friend looks thoroughly creeped out as you freeze up, grip on your phone tight.
What? Why did you...
I put it on your bike. Something slams the table you're sitting at. Looking up, your friend has stood up, scanning the area. Suddenly, they grab your phone.
We know you're here watching us, you butthole. Come out.
The other end has gone quiet.
Hey, give it back for a second.
You take your phone back.
Can you explain yourself? Please, if you're still there.
I just wanted to make sure you were okay. That's all.
What do you mean?
As the voice on the other end explained their behavior, your friend was relentlessly pacing back and forth on the lookout for anything suspicious. At the end of the explanation, you sighed. That was way too creepy, but it sounded like he didn't really know that.
Hey, listen.
Before you could get another word in, your friend snatched your phone again.
You're flippin' creepy, dude. If you don't leave Espoir alone, we'll take this up with the police.
Ugh. The other end went quiet again.
Answer me!
Click. They hung up. You take your phone back with a sigh.
Think he'll actually leave me alone?
He'd better. I was serious, you know. You have a real stalker on your hands. Yeah. You take the air tag out. You take the air tag back out and look at it with a frown. Here, I'll hold on to it. That way he won't know where you are at every waking moment.
Yeah, but he'll know where you are, and that's even worse.
After you get off work tomorrow, we should head straight to the police station. Yeah, let's do that.
Why not now? Why not do that now?
I'll walk you home. Come on. You hadn't realized how late it had gotten. Walking home, you chat with your friend and try to relieve the tense atmosphere. Get home safe, okay? You send them off and watch them walk until they're out of sight. Turning to your house, you unlock your door and step inside. Pushing your bike to the garage, you set it down against the wall and head in. Deciding to heat something up for dinner, you head to the kitchen. You put in a frozen microwave meal and set the timer. It feels like someone is watching you the whole time. As your food heats up, you decide to close the curtains. However, the feeling of being watched doesn't go away. Before you can investigate anything, the microwave beeps. You take your dinner out and sit down to eat. It's been a long day, and a warm meal will definitely help you feel more at ease. It tastes a bit off. You don't really remember how long this had been sitting in the fridge. Maybe you should have ordered something instead. Oh well. After you eat, you wash the dishes and head to your room.
Ah, man in my room, sir!
In the middle of your room stands a man. It looks like he was waiting for you. His face lights up as you enter the room.
Finished eating already? How was the meal?
What the fluff are you doing in my house?
Picking you up? What?
I'm here to pick you up. I thought I should come a bit earlier than I initially planned. You know, since you guys plan to go to the police and all, I can't have that happening.
He almost sounds apologetic.
Anyway, that's why I decided to wait here for you instead.
Oh, isn't that thoughtful? Don't do that, please.
Your head was spinning with confusion.
Wait, what? You shouldn't be here. You need to leave.
Oh, sorry, but that won't be happening.
What?
I told you already. I'm here to pick you up. Hit with a wave of nausea, you try to prop yourself up against the doorframe. You suddenly felt dizzy and weak. The man walks over, arms out, and ready to catch you. Afraid, you back up and try to get away. Your attempt fails as you hit the floor.
Oh, wait, did he? Oh, you put something in my food! Oh, you naughty, naughty boy, I know he did. That's why it tasted off. He put something in my meal. Ah, sir! How dare you study my poor eating habits?
The last thing you see before you lose consciousness is a kind smile contrasted by dark eyes. Ending 5.
Tagged. Rude. What if I just throw it away? Just,
you don't care that much.
You're like, yeet!
Holding the disc for a second, you take aim at the deepest part of the trail before throwing it into the woods. Your friend gives you an incredulous look.
What did you do that for?
What?
Why'd you throw it away? Aren't you worried or curious as to who it belongs to?
You shrug.
Nope.
Sighing, your friend pockets their phone and grabs their bike. Well, that's that then. Let's get going. You both head off after that, chatting along the way. After dropping your friend off at their house, you head on your own way home. You spend the rest of the evening winding down to mentally prepare for work tomorrow. A few hours and a warm microwave dinner later, you settle down in bed.
Okay, so last time I went, oh well, I guess my coworker's missing. What happens if I overthink for a second? Because I'm still being pretty nonchalant, and I'll look for him last ways. So overthink for a second.
The more you think about it, the more uneasy you get. What if he's dead in a ditch somewhere? Maybe he got kidnapped while waiting for you. After a few seconds of overthinking, You shake your head. It's easy to assume the worst, but rarely do your anxieties ever come to fruition. I have a feeling that this is not one of those times. This is probably one of those times where he is dead in a ditch. Except for the times that they have. With a sigh, you send off a text, wishing him well. After a bit of thinking, you decide to accept the money.
Okay, let's look for him. Let's look for him.
Sure, a free meal is good. But a meal shared with another person is good, too. You also can't help but worry if something happened. It's only been about 20 minutes or so. Maybe he couldn't have gone far. Picking a direction to walk in, you scan the streets as you walk. Not the best strategy, but it's not like you had a better one. You had no idea where the guy lived, after all. You could probably find out if the office is still right there. Who knows? What if you get lucky? Every now and then, you called his phone number as you walked. It's unlikely, but there's a chance he may answer. This continued for a while. After a few minutes of walking, you called again. You passed by an alleyway as it rang.
Uh-oh.
Slowing your pace, you lowered your phone from your ear. It was faint, but you could definitely make it out. A ringtone was coming from deeper within the alleyway. Maybe it was just a coincidence. Hanging up, you call the number again.
Oh. Oh no.
Okay, not a coincidence. Putting your phone away, you walk deeper into the alleyway. A wave of unease hits you as you get closer to the ringing.
Oh, that would be perfect for a horror movie. Just you hear a happy little ringtone as you get closer to it. Oh, that's terrifying.
Fearing the worst, you look around really quick and spot a metal pipe on the ground. You pick it up and keep venturing further in.
Oh, that's terrifying. Oh, that's scary.
Turning the corner, you feel your eyes bulge out of your skull as the smell of iron hits your nose. There lies your co-worker, with something standing over him. You can barely make out the details of the scene unfolding before you due to how dark it was. How troublesome. Did I go too far? No, maybe not far enough. The figure standing over your co-worker raises something, a bat, over their head. Fight or flight kicks in as you rush forward with a yell, shoving the figure away from your co-worker.
Nah.
Looking down at your co-worker, he was heavily injured, with blood running down his face. Thankfully, it seems like he was still alive.
Yay!
His chest heaved with effort. Looks like he's barely holding on to consciousness. Looking behind you, the figure from before is staggering to his feet.
Oh?
Who? Espoir? This guy knows me?
You're the hamster man!
Oh, I'm sorry for causing you trouble, Espoir. You'll forgive me, right?
Who are you?
Oh, we haven't met. I mean, we have, but you probably don't remember me. But I remember you.
Honey, there's blood all over you. There's blood all over you. You're covered in blood.
They're standing up straight now, facing you. You can barely make out what he looks like. Blonde hair and dark brown eyes. This guy is familiar, for sure. Sorry for troubling you. I'm sorry, Espoir. You probably think less of me now, don't you? It's not my fault, is it? I just wanted to help. I'm sorry. The man staggers forward, bat dragging on the ground. You ready your own weapon, shielding your co-worker. Get out of the way, Espoir. I'd hate to hurt you.
No way! He needs a hospital!
No. No, no, no. I'm really sorry about this.
Hey, what you gonna do with that bat?
He lunges for you. Looks like there's no talking your way out.
Chen. Beat the crap out of him with the pipe. I like channeling my inner pro baseball player.
Like a batter about to strike a home run, you swing the pipe as hard as you can at him.
Thud. Ooh.
The man falls to the ground, knocked out for good this time.
goodness, Morgan, you're just getting your butt handed to you in these games. Hopefully you didn't kill him. This time, I remember the vehicular manslaughter espoir. If I ever did fan art of Oliver Morgan, he'd be all bandaged up because he keeps getting beaten up. But it is nice to see these stalkers getting beat up for getting the hands once in a while.
You quickly take your phone out and call for an ambulance before checking on your coworker. Hey, are you okay? He's passed out too, breathing faintly.
Call an ambulance, but not for me. For these two guys, one of which I beat up.
At least it looks like he'll survive. Probably.
Hey, I'm still getting that free lunch, right? Right?
Dragging him out of the alleyway, you patiently wait for the ambulance. Looks like you won't be getting that free meal with your coworker anytime soon.
Dang it! Ending 6. Let's get food next time.
Well, that was Lucky Day, a prequel game to Dr. Morgan's counseling session.
Looks like all of our luck was due to a crazy, adorable stalker. And it is really hilarious that Oliver Morgan keeps getting his butt handed to him, and he keeps getting beaten up and ran over and hit with a pipe and punched in the face. But then again, he did put a camera in my stuffed plushie, so that's not cool. And he did steal my bike and put a tracker on it, so, you know, that's not cool. That deserves some hands, sir.
Thank you so much for hanging out with me. Take care of yourself. Have a great night, and remember, there is always hope.